our service today, page number 5. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Beloved in the Lord, let us draw near the true hearts and confess our sins unto God, our Father.
If we do something good, devil not sleeping, you know it. Good. We will start in the beginning. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Beloved in the Lord, let us draw in the true heart and confess our sins unto God our Father, beseeching Him in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ to grant us forgiveness. Our help is the name of the Lord.
Thank you.
have no strength, keep us both unworthy and worthy, that we may be defended from all adversities, which may happen to the body, and from all evil thoughts, which may assault and hurt the soul. Through Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Not even a word.
Then his disciples argued him to send her away. Tell her to go away, they said. She is bothering us with all the begging. Then Jesus said to the woman, I was sent only to help God's lost sheep, the people of Israel. But she came and worshipped him, pleading again, Lord, help me. Jesus responded, it isn't right to take food from the children and throw it to the dogs. She replied, that's true, Lord, but even dogs are allowed to eat the scraps that fall beneath their master's table. Dear woman, Jesus said to her, your faith is great. Your request is granted. And her daughter was instantly healed. This is the gospel of the Lord.
was a difficult text to digest. When you hear the story of the Canaanite woman begging the Lord for help to make her child well, it gets rough answers instead of the sweet Jesus that we know as our Good Shepherd. The end of the story, and my theme, will never give up with God, because he will never give up with you and me. From verse 28, Jesus confesses and says, your faith, great is your faith. Your faith has granted your wish. And the daughter was well. Oh God, we pray. Give us the strength of faith that trusts in you no matter what the situation is, because we're in your hands, here and beyond. In Jesus' name, Amen. Hi, Jesus, dear friends. It was always a very hard text to digest and to preach on, because we are God's family and we are used to the Good Shepherd who will let us suffer, especially when the theme and when the situation talks about great love of a mother toward a child that bears all things and produces all things that goes above everything that we can imagine and think. St. Paul writes a whole chapter in 1 Corinthians about perfect love. It's a different concept that people have about love. My granddaughter, she loves oranges. Well, if that orange could talk and talk back to her, I don't think that orange would call it love. Just to peel it off, to take the best out of that orange and digest it. We have a neighbor that has this amazing power. He just loves his amazing power. What kind of love is that? Domination. Get something under your foot and dominate it. The love of Christ and the love of God is dedication. Impersonated in Jesus, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Whoever believes in him, that is the key to the story for me. Whoever believes in him, this good lady, Samaritan, and the Samaritans were always kind of the underdogs. They were like some of the minorities looked down on. What happened to her? She heard of Jesus, she followed him. She put her trust in him. She must have been convinced that this man that walks on Syria, that this man has the power over all things. He is the great physician for soul and body. To him I have to go. I need his help, because he can do it and will do it. And what the story tells me is, love never fields for the love of her child. She endured all the disgrace that happened to her when she begged for help. And there are times, my friends, when I feel sometimes. And I'm sure that everyone has those moments too, where you feel like God is quiet. He answers not a word to my prayers. But have faith. Keep on trusting. Don't give up with God, because He'll never give up with you. And all I can say is that the all-knowing God in Christ Jesus, He must have known. He must have known what is coming up. But He put her to the test, the utmost test of faith, comparing her with the lowest grade of creature that was known in those days among Israel and the Jews. Dogs. Not good. You throw the children's whip and throw it to the dogs. You dog. How would you react? How would I react? It's such an insult. How would I? How does our society act when things like that happen? Discrimination, they would call it. Not in the kingdom of God. Never give up for the love of a child. She would endure that. And don't worry about that God cannot be persuaded. She persuaded Christ to do what she asked Him to do. Not for herself. Totally unselfish love for that child. That is dedication of the highest degree. And got rewarded by the Lord. And you notice in the story, the disciples urged Him, sent that woman away, she's crying and she's making noise and screaming. Sent her away. But you notice He did not. He did not push her aside, He did not send her away. Great is your faith, your trust. But it's not the faith that has miracles on us. Faith alone, as Luther puts it, by faith alone, it still is not that faith that people sometimes say, it doesn't matter what you believe, as long as you believe in something, as long as you have some kind of that faith. If I believe in nature, what do I get? It's the object of faith, Jesus Christ, that this good lady knew. He is God in person. And she trusted Him. She was convinced in that object of her faith and trust. She didn't trust in money, she didn't trust in anything else. She trusted in the Messiah, in the Christ, who has everything at His disposal whatsoever. And if you learn anything from that story, then that's one of the faith, and the subject of faith, Jesus Christ, is with us. All things are possible for God. And He assured us, I'm with you always until the end of time. He is that good shepherd, indeed. But there are times in life when He wishes for all of us position to strengthen that faith, to make sure that we stay connected with Him in our prayers. There may not be answered immediately, but wait some time. In times when we feel, where are you, Lord? I've heard it many times during war times, I said, people say, you know, if there was a God in heaven, how can He let all this happen? But He does. He does because He wants to have a chance to put His helping hands below your power. And He did with the Canaan woman. He gave us an example of faith and trust that never fails. The end always brings about the blessing of our Lord. There are times we have to wait. A good old lady, woman, down the street was hit by a drunken driver and cracked her hip. I wondered why where was God. She was on a mission of charity, collecting money for charity. How come? 10 years later, the neighbor calls and says, Pastor, come find over. I found Louise in the garage. She fell and broke her hip. But no. When I took her to Lutheran Hospital, the doctor, and she said, and the doctor says, what happened? And she told him the same thing. But the doctor says, no, I disagree with you, lady. That hip cracked. That hip fell apart. And that's why she fell down. But she's a lucky lady. Because long time ago she must have had an accident. And they put a steel plate on the other hip. Without that, she could never walk again. Now we have to wait again. Times when God waits. And let's you and I wait for the answer, as He did that good lady. May we trust in Him, now and always. But never give up, because He never gives up on you and me. But makes come true what He says. In my Father's house are many, many rooms, many locations. And there's a place for you and I. And the longer I'm in this world, the closer I'll get getting to my real estate in heaven. And so do you. On that note, let's keep trusting, trusting, trusting in Him. He puts you and I to the test, but He's also behind you to work with you and through you and in you. When He and His disciples went across the lake and the storm was hitting, the ship was in danger, it was bouncing back and forth, and the disciples were screaming for fear. And He was sleeping, as you know. They had to wake Him up, but He was there to calm the storm. He never lets you go more than you can bear. And you wonder sometimes how much you're able to bear. But the joy of the Lord be our strength, now and always, in Jesus' name. Amen. And now may the peace of God, which goes above our understanding, keep your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
because you are with us. Heal us of those who have been praying with the church on earth. Be with those who are persecuted. Heal the prayers of your people wherever we are and they are. Especially for this congregation. Pastor people, for those who are ill and in need of healing, be the great physician of soul and body, and give healing and power to those who cry upon thee. Comfort those who are ill, comfort those who are dying, and hear our personal prayers that we bring before you in Jesus' name as we pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And now may the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you, be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you.
after our service, we have coffee and cake in our hall. Also, we want to help to our district in Texas for people who was in this freezing weather. We will collect for Sunday's collection for Texas. If you want to make a donation to Texas, probably today or next Sunday, you will have possibility to help for brothers and sisters who have problems in Texas. Again, all blessings, Pastor, for you. Stay with us strong and welcome for coffee and cake.